میخوام خواهش کنم که مختصری از کمپین پایان دادن به اشغال غزه برای بینندگان این برنامه بگید. از چه زمانی آغاز به کار کردین و هدفتون از تشکیل این کمپین چی بود؟
The U.S. campaign to end the Israeli occupation is a national coalition here in the United States of more than 400 organizations, and our mission is to work together to change and challenge those U.S. policies that support Israel's human rights abuses and apartheid policies toward the Palestinian people, and to change our governments and our institutions' approach to this issue to support human rights, international law, and equality. And we were founded in 2002.
در این درگیری که از 16-17 روز پیش آغاز شده در غزه بین اسرائیل و فلسطینی ها، موضع شما چیه و فکر میکنی آیا تفاوتی داره با درگیری های قبلی که در سالهای پیش اتفاق افتاده بود؟
I don't think that the nature of Israel's violence and massacres toward the Palestinians in the Gaza Strip is fundamentally new. It's a repetition of existing patterns that we've seen over the years, and Israel has a very dehumanizing term for these types of attacks against the Palestinians, which they refer to as mowing the lawn. And this is part of the dehumanization of Israel toward the Palestinian people. And my take on this current round of violence is that it's one of a complete massacre where the United States is providing Israel with both the means to protect itself from Palestinian weapons, but on the other hand also providing Israel with all of the incredibly devastating weapons that it's using to massacre Palestinians by the hundreds.
مقامات اسرائیلی بارها اعلام کردند که برای دفاع از مردمشون و برای دفاع از کشورشونه که به غزه حمله میکنن، غزه رو بمباران میکنن، و همینطور بارها گفتن حماس از مردم غزه به عنوان سپر انسانی استفاده میکنه. خب شما فکر میکنید اسرائیل برای دفاع از خودش در این زمینه باید چی کار بکنه؟
Well, Israel is protecting its citizens very well from Palestinian rockets through the Iron Dome system, which is intercepting and knocking down 90% of all Palestinian rockets that are fired toward Israeli population centers. So what Israel is doing is not about self-defense, because it has the means to protect itself, but what this is really about is about inflicting collective punishment on the Palestinian people and committing terrible, terrible war crimes in the course of this brutal attack.
به نظر شما جامعه جهانی چه نقشی داره این وسط و چی کار میتونه بکنه برای پایان دادن به این درگیری؟
Currently, the Secretary General of the United Nations is attempting to negotiate for a ceasefire. The U.S. Secretary of State John Kerry is in the region attempting to promote a ceasefire, and what's needed is not only an immediate end to the violence and Israel's massacres against the Palestinian people, but fundamentally a change in the condition of the Palestinian people, especially in the Gaza Strip, which is simply intolerable. Palestinians have been living under an illegal blockade now since 2006, and this is an illegal blockade which has been condemned by the United Nations. And so what we really need is pressure on the United States in particular, from other countries around the world, to end its diplomatic protection of Israel, which allows it to continue these illegal policies toward the Palestinians.
خب کمپین شما برای پایان دادن به این درگیری ها در غزه چه کاری انجام داده و چه کاری داره انجام میده؟
Right now we're very focused on trying to pressure our decision makers, our members of Congress, the president, to end, get Israel to end its massacres of the Palestinian people. We're busy out in the street protesting, taking action in the media to try to get our point of view across, but at this particular point in time it's all about stopping the immediate carnage and massacres that Israel is inflicting on the Palestinian people. And once that ends, we'll move toward a stage where we try to pursue accountability for the crimes that Israel has committed in this latest round of massacres.
خب بعضی از تحلیلگرها اعتقاد دارن که در این درگیری های اخیر به ویژه شبکه های اجتماعی و به خصوص توییتر نقش خیلی زیادی داشتن و تأثیر زیادی داشتن روی پوشش خبری رسانه ها روی همین مسئله. شما یا با این تحلیل موافق هستی؟
I think that social media is having a huge, huge impact on the way that people view this issue all over the world, and in particular in the United States as well. Even though Israel is trying very hard to keep foreign journalists out of Gaza right now, they're nevertheless still failing in terms of trying to control the scenes of devastation that are coming out of Gaza through social media. And the fact that millions of Americans and billions of people around the world are having this really unfiltered access to what's happening in Gaza in a real time is making it very difficult for Israel to maintain this notion that it's somehow acting in its own defense when it's quite clear from these pictures and scenes of devastation that Palestinians are being massacred on a huge scale.
خب شما فکر میکنید که مردم عادی چه نقشی میتونن در این زمینه داشته باشن برای اینکه بتونن تأثیر بذارن و این درگیری ها رو یه جوری بهش پایان بدن؟ حداقل دهه هاست که ادامه داشته، اما این درگیری اخیر رو چطور میتونن پایان بدن؟
Yes, I think that the general public, no matter what country they live in, has a role to play in helping to end Israel's violence and hostility and brutality toward the Palestinians, especially governments that can do something to put pressure on the United States to end its military and diplomatic support for Israel, because the reality is that it's only because of the support that Israel receives from the United States that the international community doesn't do anything about this.
شما به عنوان یک آمریکایی چرا این کمپین رو تشکیل دادی و چرا داری در این زمینه تلاش می‌کنی برای پایان دادن اشغال در سرزمین‌های فلسطینی و به ویژه غزه؟
I feel personally very, very responsible because as an American citizen, it's my taxpayer dollars that are financing the weapons that Israel is using to massacre the Palestinian people. It's because of the diplomatic protection that the United States provides to Israel that Israel is allowed to continue its apartheid policies toward the Palestinian people. So I think all Americans, regardless of their race or religion or ethnicity, because we all pay taxes, because we all support and are part of a government that is promoting these policies, we have a responsibility to change them.
خیلی ممنون از اینکه وقتت رو به ما دادید.